Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I am going to discuss how we use the JavaScript executor method to execute the JavaScript using Selenium WebDriver. Okay, so here I will give you some examples like how we run. Okay, so like this is the Flipkart. Okay, so if we want to scroll down here, then how we do that? So Selenium will not provide any direct function to scroll down, right? So here we can use some JavaScript function, JavaScript method by which we can scroll the Windows browser down. Okay, so before like going to show the examples and that before like going to the tutorials, if you are coming first time on my YouTube channel and you have not subscribed it, so subscribe it and click on the bell icon so that when I upload any new video, you will get the notification. Okay, so now let's start. So now I am going to create some JavaScript code by which we can scroll down this. So there is a window dot scroll. This is JavaScript method. Here we can pass some coordinates, like I am going to pass 1000 1000, so 1000s I am passing, so this will scroll down to the window. Okay, yeah, just I click, you can see this scroll down here. So we can use this method to scroll down the page in the Selenium WebDriver. So now this is the JavaScript, how we execute the JavaScript method function in Selenium WebDriver. So there is a JavaScript executor interface. JavaScript executor interface, and this is implemented by the remote driver. Okay, so if I go here, I will show you. This is the remote driver class, and here this is the JavaScript executor, and this is the interface, and this is implemented by the remote driver class. Okay, so it has a function execute a script. Okay, we can use this script used to execute the JavaScript. Okay, arguments the arguments of the script may be empty. Okay, one boolean value, long, double, this will also return the value. Okay, so I will show you how we return also value using this method. So I need to typecast the driver object, okay, into the JavaScript executor reference variable like JS. Okay, so typecast here JS dot execute method, execute script. Okay, so this is optional. Second one, we can pass here the single string like JavaScript. So this is the script I have passed here. Now if I run this, then this will execute the this JavaScript on window, and you will see browser will scroll down. Actually, I need to click on this window. So in that way, close this pop-up. Let me create the code. Button text equal to X. Okay, so this will close this button. So let me add first close this driver dot find element by dot XPath and then click. And next here I'm going to use 1 2 second sleep method, sleep, so that you can see here. Okay, now I'm running the code. Yeah, you can see the here, this is scroll down. Okay, so it means JavaScript function, what I have written, that is executed on the browser. Okay, so now I'm going to show some other example. Okay, like suppose that if you want to enter the text into search input box. Okay, so we can also do this by using the JavaScript. Okay, how we do that? Let me know. Let me show. So this is the name. Okay, here, and we can create the CSS selector, this one. Okay, so how we use that, we can call here the document dot query selector. Okay, and here I will pass the CSS selector, and if I run this, then you will get the input property. Then here I can call the value equal to what value we are going to add here. We can pass like testing. If I enter this, you can see here the testing is added. Okay, like this. So this JavaScript we can execute, and this will enter the text into the input box. So the main goal is Selenium WebDriver provide the function to send keys into the enter the text, but this we can also achieve using JavaScript. So here my main goal is how we execute the JavaScript methods. Okay, so if I type this complete value here, and if I run this, then this testing will be added into the input box. Yeah, testing is here typed. You can see like this. Okay, sometimes we also required to click on a particular element. Okay, so how did we click using the Selenium WebDriver? Using the JavaScript method. Okay, so now suppose that if I want to click on this login button, so we can create the element locator CSS of this button. This is the locator, and I can call here the locator CSS selector, and then click method. Okay, so if I type this, enter this, you can see this is clicked. So same method I can use and perform the click operation in the JavaScript using JavaScript executor. Let me show. Yeah, now you can see the pop-up is open. So we can do this by using JavaScript executor. And there is one more thing. We can also execute this by using WebDriver element, web element. This is my locator. Okay, so I'm going to call here driver dot find by dot xpath. Okay, I have updated the single code. Now next I need to click on this web element using the JavaScript executor. So I can call the js.execute. Okay, here I will call the arguments 0 element. Okay, so now let me run this. Okay, so what happened? This is CSS selector. So you can see the pop-up is open. So we can also click using the babe element object. Here we need to call the arguments 0 click method and then pass the element locators. So this will click on that particular element. Okay. So now I'm going to show one more method, how we get the text using the JavaScript from the application. Okay, so let me capture some locator. Okay, so this returned login, right? So now I'm going to run this code and this will give us the return the text. Okay, so here we need to use the return method, return, okay, and then JavaScript method, this JavaScript method. Okay, so this will return a value and we can store this in a variable. This will return the object type, not a string type. Okay, so now I can convert this into a string by calling dot to method, to string method. Okay, so this JavaScript js.execute script method will return the object. Okay, so if we are using the click or these method, then in that case, this will not return any value, but let me run now. Here you can see I'm able to retrieve the login. So this is very useful method. Sometime we are, when we are clicking on particular element locators, then we find some issues in Selenium WebDriver. Generally we are getting the an IE browser or Edge browser. So in that case, this will not perform the click properly. So at that time we can use the JavaScript executor to click an element. Okay, sometime also required to get the text from the hidden elements. So we can create the JavaScript executor method, return the value, and we will get the text from that field. Okay, so hope this will help you to get understanding like what is the use of JavaScript function, JavaScript executor class interface in the Selenium WebDriver and how we use that. Okay, thanks for watching the video.